We're here on the banks of the Ovens River in northern Victoria to show you how we successfully restored a river reach for native fish using a simple four-step approach. The first step in the approach is planning, then implementation, monitoring, and the last step, communication. The first step in the river restoration program is to construct a restoration team, and members of that team can be from the funding body, the local community, angling groups, and scientists. So the aim of the restoration team is to come up with a river restoration plan that outlines all of the threats and the project aims. The second step is to choose your restoration actions with particular care to align actions with restoring ecological processes. So in this case, our actions include restoring structural woody habitat by putting logs into the water. The benefit of putting in in-stream habitat for fish is it provides them with spawning substrate and shelter. Another one of the actions, as you can see here behind me, is the construction of the rock ramp fishway, which provides fish with passage around the weir, and that gives them access to scarce resources, including food and mates. Some of the other actions include fencing off stock access to the river to prevent sedimentation buildup, replanting native riparian vegetation along the stream banks to shore up the banks and to enhance food delivery between the terrestrial and the aquatic environment. And lastly, the removal of carp from the river reduces competition, obviously, for native fish, and they benefit from enhanced food and clearly less competition. The third step in our four-step approach is monitoring. In this case, we used boat electrofishing to monitor the abundance and the change in the abundance of fish and the population structure of that fish community. Monitoring allows us to assess fish populations and how those populations change over time and whether we can associate those changes with implementing the actions of the river restoration program. The last final step in the approach is communication. It's really important to tell your clients, to let the local community and other scientists know what you found. This helps other people to develop river restoration programs for the benefit of native fish. So we communicate our findings through writing client reports, undertaking talks to the local community and school groups, presentations, and through the media, such as what we're doing now.
As a volunteer, I can see huge benefits of works done on our waterways for the community. And the benefits of this is a spin-off for tourism, attracting people to come to the area.
We've found that through restoration, we've had a 240% increase in the abundance of Murray cod and a 235% increase in trout cod throughout the system. This is a fantastic result, and we really hope that through this approach that we can help other people develop restoration programs for the benefits of native fish.